Hey everybody, Smooth Terrorist here, and this is just going to be a quick response, hopefully a quick video response to this guy, JoeClem15, and his remarks about George Zimmerman, Trayvon Martin's shooter. And I was really hoping to keep quiet on this entire subject because it's such an obvious attempt by the wealthy ruling class to drive a wedge between the American people so that they can keep us subjugated, keep us weak, keep us ignorant, keep us fighting with each other. You know, if you need any evidence of that, look no further than the fact that Obama himself felt the need to chime in about this. And there have been, you know, people get shot every day in this country under questionable circumstances, and it isn't always a big media firestorm like this. And the fact that the media has chosen to whitewash this Hispanic guy, it's just so obvious what they're doing, and it's so fucking insulting. And the worst thing is it's working. The bigots are coming out on every side. They're all coming out of the woodwork. The white bigots are coming out. The black bigots are coming out. Probably even some Hispanic bigots coming out. So they're getting what they want, and they're, I hate to add my voice to this choir of stupidity, but Joe Clem, your video really pissed me off, some of the comments you made, and I'm gonna play those without further ado, so here you go.
We have a lot of people on here saying that, oh, George Zimmerman, he isn't white, he's Hispanic, or he's mixed. And at first I thought it was an attempt to, for some white people, not all white people, to detach themselves from the incident to make sure that their race isn't responsible for, you know, what happens on a daily basis in this country or around the world. I thought it was a way to, you know, kind of ease away from it. Like, oh no, he's not white. He's Mexican. He's Hispanic. But I think there really is just a true misunderstanding. A lot of people think that black people that were saying, oh, he's white, purely because we want to find somebody to blame. But the actual truth about this is that George Zimmerman is white, and I'm explaining what I mean by that. Genetically, he's mixed, and genetically he's half white, half Hispanic. I don't know if he's half Cuban because he's from Florida, or half Mexican, or whatever. Genetically, he's of a mixed race. But to me, as far as cultural, or excuse me, as far as racial identity goes, I think how you culturally identify with yourself is what's most important, which most makes up your identity, followed by how you look and maybe how you eat, what religion you are. But first, culture. Culturally, George Zimmerman is a white redneck. And I don't want to say culturally he's white, because not all white people think like him. Not all white people are super racist and hateful. But he culturally has the mindset of a white redneck racist from the South. Only a white guy would self-appoint himself as the neighborhood watchman and walk around with a gun looking for black people, or... no, fuck that. Black people, to keep out of a gated community. That's not something that Hispanics do. That's pretty much the only thing I really want to talk about as far as racial identity and why black people are saying that he's white, even though genetically he's half white, half Hispanic. It's really irrelevant because culturally he's very, very white. Just like all African Americans have white in us, culturally, We're African American. Okay? How we act, how we carry ourselves, how we eat, how we walk, it's different.
Okay, so Joe Clem, 15, you say that George Zimmerman is a white guy, not because he's not because of his genes, not because he's ethnically white, but what makes him a white guy is the fact that he is a greedy, paranoid busybody who lives in a gated community and performs a neighborhood watch with a gun. So, in other words, according to you, George Zimmerman is white because he's an asshole. Now, I'm wondering if you could maybe understand how I, as a white guy, might have just a little bit of a problem with that. I mean, wouldn't that be like if there was some half Latino, half Jewish guy somewhere who had big spinning rims on his car and he was obsessed with status symbols and he was kind of shiftless and lazy and liked to eat lots of fried chicken, and I said, oh, well, that guy is black. Because of how he acts. You see how that's just a little bit fucking offensive? So, in other words, to you, white means evil. Right? White culture is rich, greedy douchebags who live in gated communities. Okay, that's what that means. Then I got a question for you, Joe Clem. Where do I fit in? Am I a white guy anymore? I mean, this all has me so confused that the media is like showing this Hispanic guy and calling him white, and all you fucking brainwashed lemmings are just going along with it, like yes, 2 + 2 = 5. George Zimmerman is white. We are automatons. I mean, what the fuck? They're calling an apple an orange, and you people are eating it up. What is going on here? The guy is clearly not fucking white. If he's white, what am I? What am I? Now, Joe Clem 15, to give you a little bit of background on myself, I've never lived in a gated community. And I've never volunteered for the neighborhood watch. In fact, I hate the police. I live in New Orleans. My diet includes red beans and rice and collard greens on a regular basis. I smoke weed every day. Between you and me, I even like to fuck girls with big asses. So, am I a black guy? I mean, is that how this works? I mean, do you want to, like, go hang out at the barber shop with me and maybe we can rent Madea together and eat turkey necks? I'm guessing the answer is no, because when you look at me, you don't see a black guy, you see a white guy. But when you look at a Latino who's an asshole, who, is this paranoid busybody who volunteers for neighborhood watch. He's probably the kind of guy that like took names in class when the teacher was absent and volunteered as like a hall monitor. Just a dick, a douchebag. That also makes him white. I don't like where you're going with this, Joe. I really don't appreciate it too much. I'm wondering if you're beginning to see the problem. And what about guys like Obama? What about guys like Colin Powell? And what about Condoleezza Rice? Do they count as black or are they white too? Because, I don't think Barack Obama has ever drank a grape soda. I don't think he's ever smoked a fat chronic blunt. I don't think he's down with OPP. I think that guy, according to you, is probably even whiter than I am. The point I'm making here, Joe Clem, is that a lot of people are saying that the Trayvon Martin case illustrates a need to have a discussion about race in America. And I think that's true. We do need to have a discussion about race. And apparently, we need to decide what it means to be white. Because if being white means being somebody who, is greedy and a capitalist, and they live in a snooty gated community, and they're paranoid about like people that look kind of hip hop coming through their hood, and then I don't want to be white. I don't want to be that kind of white guy. But here I was thinking that I was white because I'm an ethnic Caucasian with light skin. I guess I just really don't know what it means to be white. It's confusing living in the United States. It's really confusing. But Joe Clem, there's something I'd like you to do. Do a little research on an event that happened in the 17th century in the United States called Bacon's Rebellion. That's Bacon as in Kevin Bacon. Bacon's Rebellion. See, there was a time in this country when poor white folk and poor black folk threatened the prosperity of the ruling class, the elite. So what did they do? They started giving the white slaves more privileges and taking privileges away from the black slaves to drive a wedge between us, divide and conquer, right? That's how it works. Oh, did I say white slaves? Yes, I did. You didn't even know that they existed, did you? Of course you didn't, because you got a public high school education that was full of bullshit. You've been lied to about so much, and I bet you don't even know it. Yes, there were white slaves. There still are. Hey, I happen to be one. And by the way, could you stop throwing around terms like redneck unless you want to hear me throw around terms like jungle bunny, because it's equally offensive, and you probably don't realize that either. Oh, you're not used to hearing white people get offended by the term redneck, are you? Well, I don't think that people like Arianna Huffington or Al Gore would be offended if they heard you say redneck, because neither one of them has ever done an honest day's work outside where you get a sunburn on the back of your neck. But guess what? I have. So please, could you tone it down with the redneck shit? And by the way, you don't even seem to know what redneck means, because rednecks sit in the back of a pickup truck and listen to Conway Twitty. They don't sit in a gated community like snooty fucks, like mowing their lawn and racially profiling people. Well, I guess they do kind of profile. Anyway, Joe Clem, yeah. If being white means being evil, then what do you recommend a guy like me should do who was born white? I mean, when you look at me, you see a white guy, right? I haven't turned black just because I'm cool, have I? Does it work that way? If I keep being cool and hating rich people, will I eventually get more melanin in my skin? This is bullshit. This whole story. It's a ploy. They're scared of Occupy, they're scared of Anonymous, and they're trying to tear us apart, and it's working. It's working, and you're making it work. This has been the Smooth Terrorist, and if you like this video, and you don't want to see it disappear, then download it, re-upload it, mirror it, parody it, make it your own, because the folks at Google can't censor me unless you let them.